In this video, I'm going to discuss about crawling and indexing, which is the most important part of tactical SEO. In this video, we will cover all the errors related to your website due to which your website is not ranking. So, just look it carefully. Hello everyone, I'm Shivani Goyal, welcome in WSQN. So, let's start with the basic definition of crawling and indexing. What exactly the crawling and indexing is? So, crawling. Crawling is a web crawler. It is a software program that follows all the links on a page leading to a new page and continue this process until it has no more new links or pages to crawl. So this is your crawling. In case of indexing, as the word suggests, index. Indexing is storing and organizing the information found on the pages. The board renders the code on the pages in the same way a browser does. It catalogs all the content, link and meta tag on the pages. So this is your indexing. Now, we have one report in our Google Search Console. It's a tool here which helps us to monitor all the errors related to our website. So in crawling and indexing, in this particular topic, we will learn what are the indexing report and how indexing report works. Here, we have one report which is known as Index Coverage Report, which is available in your Google Search Console, and it shows you which of your page have been successfully indexed by Google or which page have been indexed because of an error. For each of the pages, you can get more detail about the error, and you have the option to request Google to re-index your web pages or website as a whole. Let me practically explain you how to find the errors in your index coverage report. For this, we simply visit on our Google Search Console. We simply visit on coverage and go to our index coverage report. And then we will explore these four options here. And then we will find and investigate our errors here. Let me explain you practically. Here, this is the website. In this particular website, this is the Google Search Console of this website here. This is the overview. This is the URL inspection. This is the performance part. And this is your indexing part. In your indexing, we have one report known as coverage. You have to first click on coverage. In this, we have four options here: error, valid with warning, valid, and excluded. Here you can see four status here. First, let me explain you first. For this, we have one option here. Here you can add filter in this particular report. That is all non-pages, all submitted pages, or filter to sitemap. Whatever be the pages you added in your sitemap, you can also apply filter for that. The primary crawler is your smartphone, and the last update is 7/20/22, means yesterday. Okay, so let me explain you one by one. First, we have error. It shows how many errors you have in your website. These are the pages that could not be indexed for some reason, and these pages would not appear in Google, which can mean a loss of traffic to your site. For this, what we can do, this is our error, and here we can see error detail. Now we have two type of error here. One is your server error and one is your. We have different type of error that can be occur, and in this particular video, we will learn all these errors, whatever be the possibility of any particular error and how to resolve that. We will. Here we have two type of error. So, when we simply click on one error, then we can get detail like we have affected pages, that is this, and these are the link of these affected pages. Next, we have valid with warning. Here you can see these are the details. These are the warning signs, and this is here. These are your valid links, and these are your excluded. Excluded just because of some robot.txt file, that can be possible. So these pages would not appear in Google, but that are probably intentional, not due to any error. They are just intentionally you put it in your excluded part. That is your excluded coverage. The next we have, the troubleshooting process has two parts. First is identify the error, and second is to understand the error and fix it. And as in my report, as we already know, what are the errors and what are the affected pages who are having errors. So now, the second work is to understand the error and as we already see this particular report and make sure that only the error tab is highlighted and scroll down to the detail section. And here in the detail section, as we know that we have different types of errors available. Now, the errors are grouped into categories. These are some types of errors which you can see. First is your server error, which is your pipe access error. Next, you have redirect error that can be issued regarding redirecting, that your page is not redirected. Server error pipe access means that for that particular point of time when the Google crawler crawl your website, might be there is any server error at that point of time. Submitted URL seems to be a soft 404 error. It means that you have any broken page, or when your crawler load your page, might be there is any server error due to which 404 page. Submitted URL marked no index might be your page is mentioned in your no index. Might be you block your particular link by robot.txt file. So that is a submitted URL blocked by robots.txt. Submitted URL return unauthorized request. That is your 401 error. Submitted URL has crawl issue. For this, we again need to do crawl start, and again we need to do reindexing. Submitted URL not found 404. So these are the some type of error which you can see in your website. Now let's resolve the issue. How to fix submitted URL has crawl issue error? A crawl issue means that a page has a problem and a Google cannot index it. You need to fix out what exactly is the issue, fix it, and resubmit the page. For this, what we have to do, we have to simply visit to our inspect URL button and then view crawler page and then more. These are the steps we have to. Let me explain you practically how you can do it. For this, let me click on coverage. Let me just take one URL. This is the URL. Click on this copy sign and then test this URL. How to do testing of URL? For this, we have to simply open one tab, simply enter the link here and simply click enter. If this page is actually exist, if this page is 404, it means there is an error happened. Then again, let me take another URL and let me check that. See, this page is fine. There is no issue in this page, and here we can see that we have completely detail available. So this is not your 404 error page. For this, what we can do here, we simply visit on URL inspection. And here, let me check what are the issues. In your URL inspection, what you can do, you have to simply click on URL inspection. You have to inspect your URL here. And here, you can check either this URL is on Google or not. Here you can see that URL is not on Google. Then you have to click on test live URL. In this, we are doing live testing. That is if page actually exists or not. Or you can do also live testing. Just open a new tab, mention that particular link there, and when your page is absolutely fine and now you want to re-index, that is also a kind of live testing URL. So in your live testing URL, here, just wait for a minute and then let me check this URL is actually on Google or not, or this URL is actually exists on. So here you can see that URL is available on Google but has issue. It means that is on Google. For this, you have to simply scroll, and here you can see that mobile page is not mobile friendly. That is one of the error here, and that is scrolled in the last 27 July 2022. Content wider than screen, clickable element to. When you resolve these issues in your website, after that you can simply click on URL inspection, mention that, and you can simply do re-indexing. Here we have an option here, that is re-request indexing. You have to click on that, and now your request will submit and then URL will added to a priority crawler. Submitting a page multiple times will not change its queue position or priority. That is also one. Then this is how you can do URL inspection. This is how you can resolve any error to your website. This is the best method we have. Let's move to the topic. How to fix URL has crawl issue. If your URL has crawl issue, that is one of the most common reasons why a page might have crawl issue is that some of the page resource, that is your image, your CSS, JavaScript, could not be loaded when Google tried to index the page. That can be one of the reasons. So for this, what you have to do, how to fix your submitted URL not found 440. So these kind of errors are easy to fix. What it means, it is that a page could be found by the Google bot at the time. In most of the cases, this can be a false alarm. So the first thing to do is to check that the page is correctly found or not. And how to do that? For this, you have to simply copy that link, test live, and then check whether that page is 404 error or whether it's whether the page is fine or not. When you find that your page is fine, then you have to simply click on inspect URL as we previously discussed. Then while wait to get the data for the Google index, open a new browser window and type the URL. If the page is found on the website and you want to add it on the Google indexer, then you have to click on test live button as we previously did. Click the request indexing, go back the report and click the validate. When you do validate fix, for validate fix, we have to completely resolve all the errors of your error site. If you are done with all the error part, then you will click on validate fix option. Next, we have how to fix server error 5x6. The page listed here could be assessed by the Google bot either because the server was down or not available at the time. Normally, you should not have any server error reported. If you have a lot of errors, then this means that your server has issue and you should navigate more to find out why. If you have a few errors, then most probably the page could be assessed temporarily, and this means that you can request from Google to re-index the page. For this, we have to follow one process here, that is click on one of the affected page and you will get a menu with the option on the right. And as we already discussed in our server error, as we already see that we have the list of URL available there. For this, we are simply doing inspection, and that is also one of the processes to resolve your server error. Now, how to fix redirect error? For redirect error, when you get it, means that the page could not be accessed by the Google bot because it redirects to a page that does not exist or not. And what's the procedure of fixing your redirect error? That is the same. You have to click on your inspect URL, then get more detail about the error, click on test live URL, fix the error on request indexing, and then click on validate. If everything is okay and the error is fixed, then you will see a passed message in the validation column. This is how you can fix your redirect error. Now, how to fix your submitted URL seems to be a soft 400. When you get a soft 404 errors, it means that the page was not found because it does not exist. But instead of telling search engine that it should be ignored, it returned to a valid code. And you may have pages on your website that cannot be accessed directly, but only after a user completes a specific section. For example, when you're done with your checkout part, then you will visit on your billing. So that is one of the example here. Let's say that your checkout page is only shown to after they have added an item to their shopping cart. This is one of the ways. If you still have the page listed in your sitemap, and Google will try to crawl it, but it will not find it because no item was added to the cart. So in that cases, you are facing soft 404 errors. How to fix your submitted URL mark no index? This is not actually an error. What this means is that a page was submitted for indexing to your sitemap, but it has the no index directory, which instructs search engine not to add it to their index. What you should do is review the list of the pages that have the no index directory and make sure that you don't want them to Google index. If a page was wrongly tagged as a no index, remove the page from the page directory from the header and list in the same way as we previously did. Now, how to fix submitted URL log by robots.paste? That is a page as submitted for indexing through the sitemap, but there is a rule in your robots.txt file that instructs search engine not to index. So you should follow same procedure. Check if the page are supposed to be blocked from the Google index or not, and And if you find the page should not be blocked, in that case you have to simply remove that URL from the robot to specify and again request pre-exit. Now, how to fetch submitted URL return unauthorized request, or you can see 400 whatever. It means a page is included in your sitemap, but Google can't access it because it is password protected. That type of error is having 401 error. Since these pages are not publicly available, so you should remove them from your sitemap, add a no index directory in the page header, block the directory or protected areas if in your robot.txt file. So this is one of the way to resolve this particular error. Now, how to use the URL inspection? URL inspection is a tool and which allows you to check the index status of a page of your website and troubleshoot error, or request Google to re-index your website as we previously did. To use the URL inspection tool, we have to just type any URL to the inspect area. As we already did in our demo session, you can either enter your website domain or a specific URL. In URL inspection tool, that can be used to troubleshoot errors reported in the index coverage report and resubmit your website to Google or resubmit a particular page to Google. That is the use of your URL. Now, how to resubmit your website? For this, we have to simply visit on our URL inspection tool and then we have to click on, then we have to mention our URL there and then we have to click on this. When to use request indexing feature? This is one of the most important points. Google is a very good at picking up the changes made to a website or web page. So, in the majority of the cases, you don't need to use the request indexing feature. Some valid uses are when you migrate domain, when you migrate domain from HTTP to HTTPS, when you make a website redesign, when you publish time sensitive news and you want to inform Google about it. So in that cases, you need pre-indexing, request indexing. So this is all about crawling and indexing, and this is all about all the errors related to server, related to 400 port error. In this video, we will cover how to fix all these issues. So thank you so much for watching this video.